The edge of the trading floor. Joining us now is Oliver Slope, and he's with Blue Line Futures. And happy Monday to you, Oliver. First of all, here we are in a brand new month. This corn market that started out with quite a bit of weakness is really starting to perform pretty impressively here during the day trade. And albeit soybeans, that was the other way around last night. It's almost like it was the opposite of our overnight trade.
Yeah, a little bit of a roll reversal, and that happens in the overnight trade when it's a little bit lighter volume. We always say that you got to take the volume with a grain of salt. If it's a light volume trade, that's not necessarily indicative of price action. And speaking of that, we saw a big bid on Friday in the corn market, which was encouraging. But again, that volume was extremely light, nearly half of what we saw earlier in the week. But we are seeing some more participation today and that confirmation of higher prices, which is really good to see. I'm pretty optimistic on corn here. But we really want to close out above this pivot pocket here, 380 to 382. If we can achieve consecutive closes out above here, potentially we start to spur some short covering from the funds and take us back into the mid-390s. As far as the soybeans are concerned, pretty optimistic down here as well, despite the weakness that we're seeing right now. 865 to 870 is really the support pocket that the bulls must hold. This was the lows from August and September. If they can kind of defend this throughout this week to start this month, I think there's potential to see a relief rally at the very least. The bears in control on a longer term chart, but we are deeply oversold, the longest losing streak since May. So I wouldn't be surprised to see a little bit of relief. If we do get relief, 890 is really kind of the line in the sand between the bulls and the bears that determine price action going forward.